smoking crazy while I'm off the takedown.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can probably see, the setup is like mad different. I moved back home. So I moved back home and I'm trying to figure out like my setup and how I want things to like look. I still haven't like decorated my room properly, so I'm still like finding where I'm gonna put my wig stuff and where I'm gonna put my clothes. So I just bought like a little rail to hang the clothes on for now, but I gotta get these videos done so I don't judge my room, because it's gonna look good. It's gonna look way better than it looks now. Okay, so in today's video I'm gonna be doing a hair review as always. So this time I'm gonna be partnering up with Wild African, and they sent me another wig. I've tried one of their wigs before and it was a little bit small for me, so I couldn't really get the best feel on how their wigs were, because like it was quite uncomfortable because of how small it was. But this time I'm trying out another wig. So I haven't worn the wig yet. I haven't opened it at all, so this is the first time I'm gonna see the wig in here. Let's see what's popping. As you all know, the wig comes in this little box like this. So this time I got a yaki wig, or a textured wig, I don't know what to call it. I think I'll put the proper name for the texture in below. But as you can see, like it's not kinky straight yet, but it's a bit thicker textured. Like it's not silky, it's quite like, it's more, it's thicker basically. So it's like, it's in between straight and kinky straight type thing, but it's not actually kinky straight, if that makes any sense. Yeah, so I got a bob wig. I'm either gonna look like Dora the Explorer or I'm gonna look like a bad bee. Well, let's see which one I turn out to be like. Inside doesn't have the elastic band like before, so the other wig had the elastic band in it. It's just got the tightening things at the bottom, so it's just got these tightening things here and like loads of clips inside. I'm probably gonna take the clips out because I don't really like wearing a wig cap. I might do it for this video. I don't really like wearing wig caps, but if I don't wear a wig cap when it has clips inside, like tugs at my braids and it just feels awful. Okay, I definitely need to tighten it. But first impressions.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I feel like Dora the Explorer. I'm not getting Bad B, Home to Denise vibe. Like, just watch me flip this wig. I'm just gonna style it mad different to how it looks now, and I'll be back.
Okay guys, so I'm just gonna do the normal like routine of cutting like around my ears and stuff. My gluing process is so long, so I know you like wouldn't sit through that. So I'm literally just gonna explain. I put the black got to be glue down first, I'll dry it. I'll put this got to be glue down again, leave it just a little bit tacky, and then I'll do the last step, which you see now, which is me putting the free spray on top of the glue, and then I won't dry it, but I'll make sure it's like tacky. And then once it's like tacky, I just test it with my fingers, and then I'll pull the lace down over it. This can work if you've cut the lace already, or if you haven't cut the lace already, it doesn't matter, it will work either way. And obviously I feel like everyone who wears wigs knows that the hardest part is the ears, so the ears didn't stick down, so I had to do it all over again. So once I make sure that all the edges and stuff, oh yeah, I cut the lace off as well. Yeah, cut the lace off obviously. And then once you've like, once you're happy with the way that it's glued down, take out like the hairs you're going to use for baby hairs. So when I do this, most of the time I realize that the hairline doesn't look how I want it to. So you can go and pluck it while it's on your head. That's like, that's no problem. So I ended up plucking the hairline, and I plucked out some of the baby hairs as well, because I knew that it was going to look quite thick. So once I've pulled out all the baby hair that I'm happy with, I go in with my foam before I set my edges, and the foam just helps like the frontal mount a little bit more. And then I'll go in with my elastic band, and then I'll wrap it around my head. I use an elastic band, it's not tights. You could use tights, because tights are quite good as well, but an elastic band would be perfect, because obviously it's going to press down even better. And then cut this, the extra baby hairs and stuff. You got your little fringe or whatever. And here I was trying to think, this wig needs cutting. Like, I was in between cutting it, but I thought, let me just carry on anyway and see how it goes.
Okay, so I've just put my headband on, and I'm just gonna straighten it. I'm not sure how this is gonna straighten, because I feel like when I run my hand through the hair, I feel like there's something on the hair. So I'm not sure how it's gonna straighten. Don't mind my little fringe. That's just baby hairs. I'm gonna cut them and thin them out afterwards. I'm just gonna straighten my hair. And you know what I like about the hair? Because the hair isn't like, it's that kinky straight kind of texture. It's like, sis, I just got a fresh relaxer and a fresh trim. I just got a silk press at my local hairdressers.
So guys, this bit is nothing fancy. I literally just go in and press like the front of the hair down with my hot comb, just so it can be a little bit more defined. And then I went in and straightened like the rest of my hair as well. I had to take the band off because Lord knows it was hurting. It was really hurting. And as you can see, the baby hairs are mad thick right now. That is not what we're going for. So I end up plucking them just to make them thinner. But at least I know that I've got like the baby hairs exactly where I want them. So I pluck them and make them a lot thinner. And then this time I used, what did I use to do my baby hairs? I used the free spray. So this time I used the free spray to do my baby hairs. And I just put the free spray on the little toothbrush, and then I sweep them. This is like a little bit more tedious, because you don't want to use too much free spray, because then they don't look as fluffy. Because I was going for like a fluffy baby hair look. Like, I didn't want them to look laid, if you get what I mean. I wanted them to look kind of like messy, gone with the wind type look. So I used the free spray, and I just kept putting the free spray on the toothbrush. And then what I would do is, like, once it's dried a little bit, I'd lift it off my I'd lift it off my head with the toothbrush again, so it didn't look like it was stuck down. And yeah, I think when you use the free spray to do your baby hair, but adding it to the toothbrush first, it makes them just look nice and fluffy and lightweight. And you have to excuse me, guys, because it's hay fever season and a girl can't breathe. I cannot breathe, child. So please excuse me. So yeah, once again, this wig is from Wild African. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'm going to let you watch the rest of it. Thank you guys for tuning in again. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Thank you.
Yeah, this is super. That was quick and that was easy and that was way cute. I like this. Yeah, I like this one. This is actually how I am with my hair though, guys. Like, if something's wrong, I'll just cut it. Even my real hair. Yeah, this looks good. Yeah. Okay. So, I hope everybody enjoyed this video. I hope you guys like this look. I think it's quite cute. Like, it's like cute little, like, braided front. I've done this before with my Ali Pearl hair, but I feel like crown braids are so cute, especially when you kind of fluff them out a little bit, make them look real big, real cute or whatever. So yeah, this is the finished look. I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to comment and don't forget to comment what you think about the hairstyle, and if you want to know anything about the hair, feel free to comment it down below as well. All the links to the Wow African are going to be linked down below. And yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Oh, and let me know what you think about the setup. Like, what should I do? Like, I think I might have to get a backdrop because this is a bit too much. I don't need you guys seeing all of this, honey. So let me know, guys, what you guys think. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.